Welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Hoyos, and today we're here in Santa Clara, California at Intel headquarters. Today we're going to be talking about the new Threat Director and also about the new architecture for Meteor Lake. So now we have this new architecture, the new name that we call it. We call it a 3D performance hybrid architecture. Can you tell us a little bit more about what this is?
We have had P cores and E cores, right? We have had that since Alder Lake timeframe. We still have that on Meteor Lake timeframe as well. So our compute tile that we have on Meteor Lake, that has P cores, which are designed for high performance for ST limited threading cases, such as gaming, content creation, we deliver on that. Then we have our E cores on the compute tile, which is basically there to deliver multi-threaded performance under given power envelope. And then with Meteor Lake, we added this SoC SoC tile that we have. And on SoC tile, we added E-cores as well. And those E-cores really, the objective of that is providing energy efficiency to that design point.
And what we're doing there is having the ability to have separate E-cores on the SoC tile in this thing we call the low power island. And the low power island is not just E-cores, but consists of key IPs like the media, the camera, the display, and other IPs to allow us to do a wide range of workloads in low power mode. And what's great about this is while the low power island is on, we can turn off the main compute tile. So as part of our disaggregation architecture that we did with Meteor Lake, we were able to actually break those tiles up and have the ability to turn some of the tiles off.
So let's say if you have, you know, low usage activity going on that is not scaling, it doesn't need as many cores or anything. We can run them on the SoC tile and keep the compute tile powered down. And this helps us get power benefits. But when we need that high demand, high performance work, we have our compute complex, we run things on that, and we deliver on performance as well.
So we have the low power islands, the cores that are in the SoC. Mm-hmm. Then we have the E cores and the P cores that are on the tile compute.
Yes.
And so all those three is what we call the
3D performance architecture.
So for Meteor Lake, there's a few things we really focus on there. The first is the DLVRs. DLVRs we integrated into Meteor Lake in order for us to allow fine power control of each of the IPs. It allows us to control individual tiles, but it allows us to go to the IP layers itself to control the performance of the IP, set the right optimization point based on the workload itself. In the past, we had more of a centralized power management unit. When we disaggregated, each of the tiles now have their own power management control unit, and they talk together on a centralized way so we can still have coordination across all the dies and allow us to do that. But the individual tile can be controlled and optimized for the key points they want to do. From a high-level software point of view and the OS point of view, it doesn't necessarily see these disaggregation. We give hints on how to do it and then do the optimization underneath, but that allows the power management software to be consistent from before and allows us to have that flexibility to support it. So it's somewhat hidden underneath what the software sees. The other thing we did for power management, we optimized on the fabrics itself. We wanted the fabrics to be very dynamic based on the workload and just the performance. With the disaggregation, we increased the size of our fabrics to have better performance. We have some additional traffic going between the tiles themselves, but we also am focused on the power management to do this. The best way to think of this is if a workload demands lots of bandwidth between one or two tiles or certain things that are, we can optimize the fabrics between those tiles while the other tiles can be lower power mode. And so this allows us to have that flexibility to adjust our fabrics to address the bandwidth and the speeds and the performance we need based on the workloads that are there. All this work is now tied back to the software, so the Intel Thread Director can have the ability to schedule the right thread and the right workload and the right core at the right time, and allows us to turn the other tiles off. And so that software and tying it back to the overall system software has been very important to do that. And the Thread Director allows us to give hints to the OS to actually move the threads back and forth between the different cores and do the optimization points that are there.
Okay, let's talk about the improvements I've done to the Thread Director.
Yeah, definitely. So, you know, this is kind of our continuous attempt to help improve hints that we provide to operating system in assisting them to come up with the right placement decision on our hybrid architecture. In Meteor Lake, we have our SoC tile, right? That's new. So there is SoC tile specific algorithms that are part of our enhanced power management that got incorporated into Thread Director to kind of reflect to OS that, hey, now is the time to keep the work on the SoC tile or now is the time to move the work from SoC tile, right? So, I mean, just to give an example on that, right? Let's say that I'm running some CPU intensive task on my computer Meteor Lake system, right? Mm-hmm. I have four threads and I keep my P cores active because I really need that performance back. Now if some audio playback or video playback started. Since I have my compute complex up, there's no point in waking the SoC complex, even though the work could have fit in there. Then we recommend to OS that use the e-cores on the compute tile to do that low usage work, right? But once my foreground high usage, if I'm running a game or content creation, that is finished, and I only have that low usage activity, then thread director reflects back to OS saying that, hey, the efficiency ordering has changed. SoC tile is more efficient, so the work can move there and we can power down the compute tile. So all of this gets communicated to OS from hardware in terms of this thread director table that we provide.
That's pretty cool. That's pretty amazing. And it's all focused on, you know, try to save that power and get exactly. that extra 3 hours of work in the plane.
You get extra time, and also you don't sacrifice on performance, right? Because yeah. that's one of the other objectives we have.
Can you go a little bit more in depth when it comes to power management and also on performance? So like how does it get spread across the different cores?
Yeah, great question. So if you look at our thread director table, it has kind of two components to it, right? One is the classification of work that is being run on the system. So we look at, this is like class 0 to class 3 that we have, and we look at instruction mix for that classification. We look at, you know, how much is cache bound or few other parameters that we kind of look at in there. And then we put them into class 0, basically means that it has similar instructions per cycle between P and eco, right? Not too much difference. As we go to class 1 and 2, which means that prefer P core for more performance because that is going to have more IPC. We basically provide what's the best performance core to run it on or what's the best efficient core to run it on. Right? So we provide that index, and OS then makes the decision that, oh, you know what? The user has chosen best power efficiency mode. So I'm going to use what you are recommending it as the best efficient core to use. Oh, user is using best performance mode. I'm going to use the best. So we provide from hardware side all the information to operating system. Operating system then uses it with its own goodness to use right columns, right rows, and then it comes up with the placement decisions.
We've really been focused on having, from the very beginning, it's focused on having the most power efficient SoC ever with Meteor Lake, and we really set out to achieve that. It is a combination of the IPs that we did, the disaggregation, but also the thread director. It comes together there, and the partnerships with OS. Microsoft's been a great partner. We've been working with them very closely in order to have this really work and really be seamless, and really excited about this, having this full range of giving that great performance and great battery life.
I mean, think about it as a first step in our journey for disaggregation, right? We are going to double down on this. We have more products and architectures coming down this pipe. And then as we put more Meteor Lakes out there, get feedback, use that to improve our next disaggregation step that we have coming up.
You don't have to choose anymore. In the past, maybe we would focus highly on performance or you get battery life modes. With Meteor Lake, you get the best of both worlds. You get great performance when you need it, based dynamically on the application and workloads, but at the same time, you get great battery life. It's all done under the hood. Software and optimizations there is dynamically done to give you that great. So it's no longer a trade-off, it's that you get best of both worlds.
As you can see, Meteor Lake, from an architecture point of view and also from a product point of view, has a lot to offer. From new AI, new graphics, new process technology, a completely new type of architecture when we go from monolithic to disaggregated, brings a lot of new features. Thank you for watching with us, and please stay tuned for more videos that will be coming your way.